valid, but at the same time, that we're aware of it, that if you have an abnormal glucose, you shouldn't ignore it. Whether it
and
be
I, and
waiting,
I also,
yes, I agree with that.
Waiting, repeat
I agree
the
with
test,
that.
Do additional tests if necessary, and make the necessary lifestyle changes first.
Couldn't agree more with that.
And here's the thing also that I think people need to understand. We are talking about a fasting blood glucose. There's another simple blood test that you do not have to be fasting for called an A1C or hemoglobin A1C. That is, by a lot of experts in the field, more valuable than a fasting glucose because it tells us the level of blood sugar that your red blood cells are exposed to over a 3-month period. I order that and draw that blood test routinely in my office, and women listening can ask their OBGYNs to do it because polycystic ovarian syndrome, or PCOS, increases the risk of type 2 diabetes 5- to 7-fold. A woman who's had diabetes in pregnancy has an increased risk, and that is a simple test. And I completely agree with you, Travis. When I get a borderline number, here's what I say to the person. You're gonna be back in a year or 6 months, varies. This is our warning sign. This is our red flag. I want you to be more aware of what you eat, be more active, and we are going to follow this. I would rather see it as the glass is half full. I would rather know that someone is at risk and try to change behavioral modification and lifestyle issues before some other doctor says, whips out the prescription pad. We're on the same page.
But here's my biggest issue is we should know, if you're watching this show, you should know what your fasting blood glucose is. If you've never had that test done, you should, because a third of diabetics in this country who actually have full-blown diabetes don't know they have it. So you should be aware of your number. Getting back to, so prediabetes is something, it's language we've used as doctors for years and years. When you make it a public health campaign, my only concern is, it's so arbitrary. If your fasting blood glucose is 99, well, you're fine. If it's 100, you're prediabetic. Mm-hmm. And so you have to understand that one person is labeled as fine, one's pre-diabetic, and again, these numbers, what I don't like, or what worries me about this campaign is if you look and break down the actual numbers, an estimated 2 to 3% of these 86 million will develop diabetes in 3 to 5 years. Mm-hmm. 2 to 3%. So, yes, be aware, but then if you look at, the CDC came out with a figure that said 20 to 30%. Pre-diabetics. But again, it's how are you defining pre-diabetes?
Travis, you know what the answer is? Dr. Travis Stork for Surgeon General.
Yeah. I have way too much fun hosting the show. Yeah.